What's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going to talk about meteors, meteorites as they enter the Earth's atmosphere. Are they hot or cold? Starting off over here at the American Meteor Society, we're in the middle of three active meteor showers right now. The Orionids and the Southern and Northern Taurids. And the meteor activity is definitely picking up around the world. The list of major fireball events over here at the American Meteor Society is increasing every day. Saw four events on the 16th, one on the 17th, two on the 18th, two on the 19th, and one on the 20th. Something unusual entered the Earth's atmosphere last night, just after midnight, between 12 and 1 a.m., witnessed by multiple people in multiple states, had video footage of this object that, oddly enough, was traveling south to north. We're going to come back and take a look at that here in just a moment. But first, here at the website, quick look at the Schumann resonance. Not much going on, a little bit of background noise. Everything's pretty quiet for the most part. Looking at the Earth-facing side of the Sun. It too is quiet for the time being. The moon is in full phase, 100% illumination, October 20th of 2021. Hopping over to the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera, looking at the seismographs that monitor the mighty supervolcano. All in all, it too is pretty quiet. No earthquake activity to speak of. There is an unusual event going on in an area known as the Upper Falls. That's in the northern part of Yellowstone Lake. Not quite sure how to interpret this. Looks like pulses of possibly magma in the caldera. There's a couple of red vertical lines. Those indicate small earthquake activity, but at the time being, not anything major going on at the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera. I want to take you guys now back to the American Meteor Society. There's definitely been an increase in activity, a significant increase, just in the last week. There's also a video posted down here on the lower right out of Seattle. This was not reported at the American Meteor Society as a major event, but it was a bright fireball early on the morning of the 19th. I'm going to zoom in. We're going to take a look at this fireball as it slowly enters the atmosphere above Seattle. Each time it pulses, it's fragmenting, or they call that ablates. It's coming apart because of the intense pressure caused by the incredible speed. That thing was probably moving somewhere in the neighborhood of 10 to 20,000 miles per hour, interacting with the molecules in the atmosphere, and not only molecules, but gases in the atmosphere. And when these things start to fragment under the very intense pressure, again created by the high speeds, they glow, they emit light. And sometimes, like a comet, they'll emit a very long, very photogenic tail. Very briefly, it only lasts for just a few seconds because they're moving at such incredible speeds. But last night, there was something unusual that came into the atmosphere above the Central Plains, was witnessed from multiple states: Illinois, Indiana, Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, Ontario up in Canada, Pennsylvania, Tennessee, Wisconsin, and West Virginia. This was just after midnight last night, between midnight and 1 a.m. on the 20th. There was something large that entered the atmosphere. It had a long, dramatic tail as it was falling apart, coming through the nighttime sky. A gentleman down here in South Central Indiana, he goes on to share his experience last night at 12:44 Eastern Daylight Time, and that would be on the 20th. He said this event will be on many home security systems from Southern to Central Indiana. I'm pretty confident. He goes on to say, my first thought was space junk, but traveling from south to north, I watched it until I couldn't see it anymore, which was a straight line to the north, and then it looked like it broke apart in several pieces. I do have video footage that was submitted to the American Meteor Society by multiple people. Video footage that was submitted by Chris Johnson, I want to share with you guys. But first, another event on October 19th of 2021. A meteor was caught on a dash cam out of Rogers, Arkansas by Alexander Freeman. This too was submitted to the American Meteor Society. This was a very bright meteor, very quick, coming through the atmosphere at extreme speeds, had a small tail, and then evaporated almost instantly. Now we're going to the event from last night, October 20th of 2021. This is what Chris Johnson saw from Michigan, again last night between 12 and 1 a.m. And you can see this was moving through the sky at a very high altitude, was leaving a long debris field, and normally that does indicate some sort of space debris, quite possibly even a satellite. But it was traveling in a unique direction from south to due north, like this gentleman here noticed from south central Indiana. And that's what perplexed him most of all, was the orientation of travel. South to north is usually not the way things orbit the Earth. If this thing was coming back in from Leo, low Earth orbit, it more than likely would have been moving from left to right, typically west to east. Moving south to north was a bit unusual, but more than likely it was some sort of a man-made object. What it was, nobody seems to know at this time. Looking at the list of near-Earth objects over here at spaceweather.com, the list is growing as there's a lot of larger NEOs approaching the proximity of the Earth. Not necessarily going to be problematic for the Earth, but it seems like these larger asteroids bring smaller ones with them when they travel inside the inner solar system, especially close to Earth. We definitely see an uptick in meteor activity, and we're in the middle of three meteor showers, so it would be a good time to go out and check out the nighttime skies. If the skies are clear, you may encounter a nice bright meteor in the nighttime sky. But looking at the 21st of October, the last time I checked, there was one event. Now it's up to four. So we'll look tomorrow for the 22nd, and then we'll continue to check the 23rd, 24th, and we'll watch this list grow over the coming days. Now I want to go back to the question, are meteors hot or cold when they enter the Earth's atmosphere? One thing about space, where meteors come from, it's very cold in space. It's a vacuum, and there's no molecules in space to vibrate. The vibration of molecules is what generates heat, and heat is measured in temperature. They're actually two different things. Temperature and heat are different. Heat generates temperature, but it's caused by the vibration of molecules. If we look at the layers of the Earth's atmosphere, you get up to the mesosphere, it's very, very cold. It is like negative 90, negative 100. In fact, it's been measured at minus 130 degrees Fahrenheit. You can come over here to windy.com, go to the satellite view, go down and click on these cloud tops, and it'll give you the approximate temperature of that location. Right now, I've clicked on some clouds in the Caribbean Sea, and the cloud tops here in this location are showing a negative 70 Celsius, which is around negative 94, negative 95 degrees Fahrenheit. So what I'm getting at is the temperature in the upper atmosphere is very, very cold. So anything entering the upper atmosphere, if it's not cold already during its journey through the upper atmosphere, it's going to get real cold real quick. But the thing of it is, meteors that are traveling through the atmosphere, they're not meteorites until they enter the atmosphere. They're meteors outside, meteorites when they enter the Earth's atmosphere. They're cold to begin with because outer space is cold. One thing I used to compare and still do, the tails behind these meteorites that enter the Earth's atmosphere, their sparks sometimes flying off the backsides of these things, reminds me of a grinding wheel creating friction on a piece of metal, and those sparks that fly off of the grinding wheel at the point of contact. If you've ever been around any of this type of equipment and put your hand right over here by these sparks, they're not even hot. And by the time those glowing sparks reach the ground, they're no longer even glowing. It's just a temporary glow created by the intense speed of this wheel that's turning very, very fast, creating friction that's creating that spark. Kind of like we see in the nighttime sky sometimes. And it's the same basic principle in the nighttime sky when a meteor comes through the atmosphere. It generates friction right there at the point of contact with the molecules in the atmosphere. And not only are there molecules that are creating heat, there's also gas in the atmosphere that creates this glow at the point of contact where the meteor is entering the atmosphere. Depending on what kind of meteor it is, if it's very icy, it may have a very long tail. If it's not very icy, then it may not have a very long tail. It can have something very brief like you see right here, and these things are not hot. I've touched them myself. It's basically like light. By the time the ambers fall on the ground, there's no light left. It's just very brief, and they're moving at a very high rate of speed, much like a meteor that we see in the nighttime sky. So combined with two things, the meteor is cold as it's entering the Earth's atmosphere, because the vacuum of space is like 400 below zero. It's very, very cold in the vacuum of space. So these objects are going to be cold anyway. So they're coming from a cold environment in space. They're entering the Earth's atmosphere, which is cold. We can measure over here at Windy and see that the top of that cloud is negative 94 degrees Fahrenheit. You have a cold meteor traveling through here. Now all of a sudden it's interacting with the molecules in the atmosphere, creates friction. That friction is creating light. That light disappears very, very quickly. It's not even hot. It's not even hot to touch. So when that meteorite lands on the ground, more than likely, it's going to be cold. It's not going to be hot. Let's put it that way. As this thing is coming through the atmosphere at incredible speeds, anywhere from 10, 20, 30,000 miles per hour, it's going to come apart. It's going to come apart in small and larger pieces. And those pieces are moving through the atmosphere at a very high rate of speed. And remember, it entered the atmosphere cold. It's entering a cold atmosphere, so more than likely when this thing lands on the ground as a meteorite or a collection of meteorites, it's more than likely going to be on the cool side opposed to the hot side. And I've read articles where people have found meteorites soon after they've landed on the ground, and one person found one that actually had frost on it. So to answer the question, are meteorites hot or are they cold once they enter the Earth's atmosphere and land on the ground? If you ask me, I'd say they're cold. Thanks for watching. Have a super day and be safe out there.